In this video, I'll be teaching you experience how to file your tax identification number. Now, tax identification number is also referred to as TIN, and you file it at the Federal Inland Revenue Service. Now, one of the major reasons why you need to file it is because you need to pay your value added taxes, as well as you need to pay taxes for your company, your business name, or your NGO. So these are some of the reasons why you are required to get your tax identification number. Now, personal persons have tax identification number, so immediately you open your BVN and you get a BVN number, you automatically get a tax identification number. But as against a company, a business name of an NGO, I'll be explaining to you guys how to get your tax identification number without even going to Federal Inland Revenue Service. Now, a lot of people go to Federal Inland Revenue Service to get their TIN, but you don't need to do that. Now, I'll be taking you step by step on how to get your tax identification number and what you need to get it. So one of the first things that you need to have before you can get your tax identification number is your certificate of registration. You need to get your certificate of registration. So once you have that alone, it's okay. So immediately you get your certificate of registration, I'll be taking you to why you need it by the time you begin to register. Now, if you want to register for your tax identification number without going to Joint Tax Board, I'll show you the website now. The website you apply for your tax identification number is Joint Tax Board. So all you need to do is type Joint Tax Board website. So if you don't know the full name or the full website, so the website is Joint Tax Board, it's www.jtb.gov.ng. So once you type it on Google, you see it at the first page on Google. You click on it, and then of course you allow it to load. After it must have loaded, it will bring you to this specific website. Now, if it didn't bring you to this website, you know that you are at the wrong website. So it will bring you to this specific website. Once it brings you to this specific website, you go to business. So under business, you click on register for tax identification number. And also in this video, I'll be sharing with you guys on how you can verify your tax identification number. So if you want to verify it, I'll be taking you through how you need to verify it. So for individuals, because like we said, both individuals and non-individuals get a tax identification number. And like I've said, immediately you get your BVN, you have a tax identification number for individuals. All you need to do, if you want to know what your tax identification number is as an individual, you can click on this link. Once you click on this link for individuals, you click on it and then you put your BVN number or your name and so on, you'll be able to get your tax identification number. But because we are not doing that now, we are actually checking for tax identification number. You want to register for tax identification number for our company. So once you do that, you click here. So once you click here, you allow it to load as well. So once you allow it to load, it takes you to this website. This is the website you actually use to get your tax identification number, and this is where your certificate of registration or your incorporation is very important. I will not be filling all this information because I'm not registering for tax identification number now, but I'll tell you how to fill it and everything you need to know. But the first thing you need to know is that this tax identification number is for businesses and companies, so you cannot register for NGOs. Yeah, if you want to register for NGO and want me to make a video on how to do that, comment below and make you a video on how to do that as well. But if you want to register for business and company, this is where you register. Then another thing you must know is that all these red dots here you are seeing here means that the information here are very, very important. So you must fill this information. If you don't fill it, it won't be accepted. In fact, you would not even be able to click on this submit under here. Now, once you know that, then all you need to do is, first of all, under this organization type, you type the type of the organization, whether it's a business name or whether it's a partnership or company or and so on and so forth like that. Then you type the registration number of the business, then you type the registered name. Now all these informations are informations that are contained when you were registering a company. So let's assume the name of my company is Ogunleyan Israel Limited. So you put the registration number on your certificate of registration that was given to you by CAC when your lawyer registered it for you or your accountant. So you put the registered number there, and you always find it at the face of your certificate of registration. So if you have not gotten your certificate of registration, kindly inform your lawyer to get possession of it. Then of course your registered name, that's Ogunleyan Israel Limited. Then your main trade name, that's the name you use to trade. Sometimes company's registration name can be different from the trade name. Then of course you use your phone number. You have to fill this one as well. Then you might leave this second one because the red dot is not there. Then of course the email address. Then you put your date of commencement, that's the date the company was registered. It also included in your certificate of registration. Then you put your date of incorporation. It's also inside your certificate of registration. Then of course you put the sector, which particular sector is your business involved in. Now, if you have checked all these sectors and you have not seen where your business is in, all you need to do is go to other service activity and click on it. Once you click on it, it will also suffice. Then also the line of business. So of course you put what kind of business you are doing. Then of course the country, which is definitely Nigeria. Then of course the state. That's the country, mean that the country where your company was registered in, which is Nigeria. Then of course the state, whether it's in Lagos, Abuja, or your state, Cross River, and so on and so forth. And make sure, like I said before, that all the red dots must be filled up. Then of course the local government, then the city, then the street name. Now when you are writing the street name, make sure that it is very, very correct. The street name is very, so that in case you want to get a letter, you'll be able to get it. Then of course the street number, whether it's number 12, number is number 14. Your financial year begins when you register. That's about a year. You can decide to leave it if you like, but it is the year that you registered your company. Then of course the financial year ends at the end of that particular year. Then of course the share capital, when you're registering your company, when it's a business name, the share capital could be low. For a company, the minimum share capital is 1 million. So from 1 million upward, if it's a company, for a business name, you can write any share capital. And like I said, of course, you can also leave it. You could also leave this information because they are not important as well. But if you have the information with you, you can fill it up. Then of course, you put the name of director. So if you are not a director, but if you are a proprietor, you put your full name, you put your phone number, then of course you put your email address, your address, your contact address, then the number of shares you have. That's if you're a director. And then you can also add additional directors to it. So once you have done that, once you have filled all this information, you click on add so that it will add it. So you must make sure that you are either a director if it's a company, or you are a proprietor if it's a business name. So you make sure you fill all this information. They are very important, because if you don't fill them, you'll not be able to submit. Then of course you make sure you click on this, tells them that you are not a robot, that you are a person registered, that it's not a robot registering. Those are some of the safeguards. After you might have done that, you submit. So once you submit, then you'll be sent a message that it has been successful, and they will generate a tax identification number for you within 24 hours. So that's actually how to generate your tax identification number. Now, after you must have generated and you want to verify your tax identification number, so you come back to where the second page that we landed when we wanted to register for tax identification number, then you click here. So once you click on here, you type the full information of your company, that's the date of incorporation, which is also stated in your certificate of registration, and also your BVN or NIN or CAC registration number, as the case may be. And then you click on here, and then you submit. And once you submit, it will verify whether it has actually been registered or not, whether your tax identification number has been registered. So that's actually how to verify whether that tax identification number you registered is actually true. And finally, if you want to check, maybe you are a curious person just like myself, and you want to confirm whether what we are saying, that an individual has a tax identification number once you have a BVN, all you need to do is come back to that same page and click on here. You fill this information, that's your date of birth, and then also you also include your BVN number. So you click your BVN number and you type it, and once you type your BVN number, you click on here and then submit. And once you submit it, it will bring out your tax identification number as an individual. So that's actually how to get your tax identification number. Now, the information I was saying I wanted to share with you guys is that this process is only available for business name and companies, but it is different from NGOs. Now, if you want to know how to register for tax identification number for NGOs, kindly type on the comment below telling me if you want to, so that I will know, and then I would make a video on how to get your tax identification number for NGOs. So that's actually how to get your tax identification number in Nigeria.